the video laryngoscope. Sometimes if there is any difficult intubation, then we use video laryngoscope for intubation. I hope that you find this video useful. If you would like to see some more videos, please press on the subscribe button and also press on the bell button. If you've got any comments, please write a few comments down below. So let's watch the video at first, and then we'll talk through the various aspects of it. Thank you very much. We have made sure that the patient has got C-spine precaution. We anticipated that it will be a difficult intubation. So we have used the video laryngoscope. We use the CMAC and a bougie. So I'm going to show you the video here. So at first, we have made sure that we put the video laryngoscope into the mouth, and we can see the tongue, and that is the epiglottis. The tip of the video laryngoscope is into the valicula. There is quite a bit of secretion, and because of the big tongue, it was a bit difficult in positioning the video laryngoscope. I have tried to put the video laryngoscope in the middle so that the epiglottis can be pushed upwards. But as you can see, that the tip of the epiglottis, tip of the video laryngoscope is actually to the left of the midline. So the epiglottis did not move that much. So what we'll do now is we try to put the bougie, but because I cannot see the vocal cord very well, I have gradually taken the video laryngoscope out. And now I am putting it back, making sure that the tip of the video laryngoscope is in the middle. Now you can see a beautiful view of the vocal cords on the right and on the left. And you can see the adenoid cartilages and this blue thing that is the bougie that I have just introduced. And under the guidance of the bougie, now I am going to introduce the endotracheal tube. And as you can see, this is the endotracheal tube. And that is the black line that is just passed through the vocal cord, which means that we are satisfied that this patient's intubation is completed. So let's go through this once again. As you can see, we'll go through it's in slow motion. So there is quite a bit of secretion around the epiglottis. And this is this area that you can see here, that is the epiglottis, and that is the valicula here. And the midline should be here, that is where the ligament is. And gradually then we have taken the video laryngoscope out, and now you can see a very beautiful view of the vocal cords. So that is these are the vocal cords. This is the right one, this is the patient's right, and that is the left. And we are passing through between the vocal cords. We have introduced the bougie. And after the introduction of bougie, under the guidance of the bougie, then I have introduce the tube. So that is the end of the tube, and that is the black line that we need to keep an eye on. As long as the black line passes through the vocal cords, that means we can take the bougie out, and we can secure the tube at this position after inflating the cuff. And that is how the intubation is done with the video laryngoscope. In this particular occasion, we have used a CMAC, but the similar principle is applied with a glidoscope and other video laryngoscopes. Usually we do this if we anticipate that there is some difficulties in intubating a patient. All right. What are the pitfalls? If you have any questions, please feel free to ask. I'm very happy to answer to your questions. All right, thank you very much. And for any further information, please get in touch. You can contact me through email or Twitter, or you can go through my website. Once again, thank you very much for watching, and see you soon. Bye for now.